had huge good bookings. But within a span of 7 days, between 16th of March and probably around 22nd March, we had cancellations of business worth $2 million. And we came to a point by 24th, practically the facility was empty. Yeah. On 25th, we closed down the facility, both the hotels, completely. There was no point in running it because there was no guest.
Since the pandemic, hoteliers have been counting massive losses. Five-star luxury hotels, Imara Ole Sereni and 254 Ole Sereni, are among many hotels that turned their business upside down due to the pandemic, which has shaken the hospitality industry.
So within a span of 7 to 10 days, from a busy, buzzing place to completely empty, huge cancellations, we had to give refund to our advance bookings. It was a complete disaster.
It was a devastating experience. They had to declare redundancies and reduce their staff from 400 to 200 employees.
It was a question of survival then. Our industry as such is, you know, basically capital intensive and labor intensive. We already had this huge facility created, constructed, and ready for business with help from KCB and no guests. And labor, 400, keeping 400 staff without any earning, again, is difficult.
When government restrictions started easing up, the two hotels began opening up and rebuilding slowly. And to attract business, they decided to market the four-star 254 Ole Sereni as a three-star facility to cater to the mid-range requirement of guests. To their surprise, this attracted the local clientele.
Majority of business is local. Almost 80 to 90% is local. International has completely become a trickle. But local business we are getting, and that's why we are surviving.
For now, the hotels are making enough to pay its employees and expenses.
Kenya fortunately has a good and big middle-income population, which is growing. Yeah. So that has given us the confidence and the boost.
Fortunately, its banking partner, KCB Bank, has also given them a moratorium on their loan.
Relationship with KCB goes back to now almost 10 years. KCB first stepped in 2011 to fund our Ole Sereni project. 2014, we started planning Imara. We got the funding of $21 million from KCB on a project cost of $28 million. Yeah, so it was a 75-25 allocation.
Imara Ole Sereni, situated on the periphery of the Nairobi National Park, is a 15-story, five-star luxury hotel that caters to the MICE, that is meetings, incentives, conferences, and exhibitions market.
What we realize is there is not really a good high-class world standard meeting facility, conference facility available in the town. So we thought we'll bridge in that gap where people are looking for big meeting spaces, residential conferences.
The hotel consists of three basement car parks, which can accommodate up to 450 cars, with additional outside parking, which can also accommodate 100 cars. Depending on the seating configuration, the main ballroom can seat between 600 to 1,000 people. There are also 7 boardrooms, executive meeting rooms, restaurants, bars, and a banquet facility.
We are sure and we are positive that once the COVID is over, these facilities will be unique and one of its kind, not only in Nairobi, but in East Africa.